Hey everybody, it is March the 19th at 3:45. I am going to be gluing the tops together today. Some of the things you will need for this is obviously the tops. I've got a bucket of warm water there. The sanders I use, I collect the sawdust, and it's in this container. The glue, I've got, because I biscuit jointed these, they come in two sizes, 20 and 10, and which are these things? These are the 20s. And you will be also needing, clamps, which I do have over here. Okay. So first thing I like doing is, on this one board here, you can see that there's a crack there. And on the other side as well, too. And just flip this one here. We're okay. That one there will need to be filled up, too. So, yeah. What I will do is take the glue and pour it along the edge here of the crack. And then what I will do is go across the crack with the glue to push some of it down. Into there. Then I will grab some sawdust, sprinkle it on top of the glue here. Zeus, no. Hey, you don't do that. You don't want to have to take you to the vets. Hey, no. Zeus. Stop that. And then you just keep going like that. And push it in. By going across. And then what you want to do is grab your rag next. And wipe it off. And as you're wiping it off, it will help get everything into that crack a little bit better. And you want to try to get as much of the excess stuff off as you go along as well too. It's okay if it's dripping. do the same thing to this one here. Good. Gotta push some of this sawdust into the glue. sometimes it'll get gunked up on the reg, and sometimes you'll have to go over a couple of spots that you did. Because if the crack's big enough and wide enough, it'll drip down there, which is what you're wanting to have happen. Because this is acting as a wood filler, pretty much, for you. Sometimes if you see a couple of cracks somewhere else, you can do there too. Now, I'm doing this in the house because I got a dehumidifier here in the house. And my shed is usually at 16 Celsius. But the house right now, I got the furnace at 69 Celsius. So it's a much warmer, 69 degrees. And I do know, I don't know what it is in 69 degrees is in Celsius. I'd have to look at it, but I do know it's a lot warmer than 16 Celsius. This will help the wood, because I am making it wet again and I am gluing it, both with the dehydrator going, dehumidifier going, and that heat going, it'll dry out much quicker. All right. Gotta do it to this side here too. I have a tarp on the floor because I don't want to get glue on the any glue to get onto the floor. Gonna work on this one here, this crack here. More. Okay, I'm going to show you a spot down here. You can see, I don't know if you guys can see, good enough, but it's starting to go into that crack there, the glue, and then it's coming out the side. So that's why because it's gluing that crack back together, and with adding the sawdust, it helps thicken up the glue there to hold everything together. Sometimes you'll need to put a little more work into it when you're doing this. Watch out there, Zeus. You're in the way. Move. Zeus, out of the road. You're in the way, Zeus. this to some spots. Like this corner here, it's got some indents into the wood. So you gotta really, you wanna get that glue out of the, in the corners and stuff where, like this one particular corner here, because it will show up on the, when you go to stain it, it will show up. And no matter what you do, whether you use stain, wood stain, diluted latex paint, there is virtually nothing you can do to get the glue to change colors. Now this end right here where I showed you, because it's cracked right through the whole thickness, when I go to clamp it, the glue now that's in there and the sawdust, when I clamp it, it's going to be getting glued at the same time. So it's kind of a... good thing, I suppose. I'd rather do it right away, like I am now. Some of this using at least this particular wood filler, type of wood filler, because of the glue aspect of it. Same thing when I did it here is gonna, that glue will help hold it. That's how bone dry this wood is. I think my mother gave me these these the things here that I'm using for tops. I do know they came from a log cabin. And if they're, I've got some other tops that I'll show you at the end from that a log cabin. So, and they're about, though I know those other ones, my mom said they were 200 years old. And it's cedar, so, and this is looking a little like cedar. So, as I'm dampening it up. So, and it kind of smelt like cedar when I was cutting it, with the chainsaw, at the beginning of this project. The cedar legs there are cedar, and these, when I was planing it using the skill saw on it, it's they both smelt relative, like pretty close to the same. So, this is old wood. Now that this is done, let it sit like that for a little bit. And then, and so what I'm wanting to do is make sure I've got. Okay, good. Let this sit for a little while. And I'm going to show you the pieces I've got that I'm talking about. Now, this bench that I made here, this piece, this back piece, this side piece, there, and that one there. This piece here, this piece here, this leg here, and then that one that's over there are all 200 years old, and that's from that 200-year-old log cabin. I got two more outside that I have used for benches, and what I think, in fact, I'm almost 100% sure, because when I looked at these ones, before I planed them and that, they had bandsaw marks in them, like, they, were, like, those were the edge pieces, the outside pieces. And then these ones I got here are the middle pieces in from the top and the bottom. So like they were cut into separate pieces. Now I'm going to hit the pause button for the recording and let this part dry and up a tad bit. And then I will be back. Okay, I'm back. Now, the next thing I have to do with these, is just give that. Add a bit of a wiping there. Just like that. Sometimes it'll that glue that we put in the cracks there will drip out. Now, the next thing is I put on the, this is the gluing edge here with all the things for the biscuit joiner I put in. You want to get those little grooves I put in the side here filled up with some glue for sure. Right. Then what you want to do is spread it out. Doesn't have to be too fancy. You want some of the glue in those grooves for sure. Like I said, because that's where the biscuits are going to be going. Now, because this one is going to be standing up fine, just perfectly for me. Putting the biscuits in. And then some of that glue will want to come out. Get some the biscuits wiped up with glue there a little bit. You want to make sure they're in there properly. Not too much like, oh, one edge is off, up and whatever, on the one side opposed to the other side. And I'll show you how this all looks. Okay. That's what it's supposed to. The glue isn't, like I said, the glue doesn't have to be too particularly fond, like finicky about it. Because we are going to glue the other one. Put glue on the other piece here. One thing to keep in mind, remember I marked on this here. I had put a B on the bottom at the same end on both of these boards on this thing. You got to make sure that when you do this, they're at the same end and you can see the both of them. You want to make sure you got a nice good bead of glue here on these things. Get it even into those where those biscuits are going to be going. Right, finger washed off. And then the very next thing you do is go my clamps. Move this stuff here. And need my other clamp, one more for this. Very careful when you're sliding it over like this. Okay. Now, I've got these two sitting on the top side. Now, this one here is going to have to go on the bottom side. Okay, now I am going to take a look at this. That's not going to work exactly. You got to be very, very, meticulous in how you do this. Okay. And then I like to run a little strip of glue down the thing there. I get some sawdust going here so I can rub it in. Just wipe it down. If you see any knots with any holes or the cracks you filled up from before, we can always use some of the access in there. As you can see on this end, some of the glue from the cracks have started to drip out, so that's a good thing. Then, very carefully, bring it up like this. I will have it sit on at least a clamp so it's not sitting on the wood, and I gotta do the same thing to this side here. Get a bit of glue in here. Couple where the knots are there. Right. Right, start rubbing the sawdust in. Now it's time to wipe it down. Right, the sander will get the rest of it. Now, like I said, you always want to get as much off as you can now while it's still damp. Sometimes you got to play with a couple of spots here. I got a little spice shaker thing here where you put, well, I had seasonings in there. And then some spots, like I said, we'll need an extra tad little bit of sawdust in there. All you got to do is when you sprinkle it on and rub it in. Okay, now this is going to take about 24 hours. Hold on a second. Check the glue here. Okay, I gotta let the clamps on for about a half an hour and then let it sit for 24 hours. Now I'm gonna be leaving it on, for 24 hours. I got enough clamps to do one of the side tables. After I put up this video, so when all that's said and done for, I will have you guys back. Now here is the legs and the pieces of wood that I have from before, earlier on. I'm going to show you how I attach them, because they got to be attached from the to the leg, and that I've done one, which is where the camera is sitting right now.
Try to get a little more light here.
I don't know if that helped, but I did a little bit. So with this one, this is one of those end tables, and because the bottoms here on this one, it goes down and then it kicks out, and then this one goes down, straight down, and kind of curves in a little bit. So I'm wanting the one end to stick out further than the other end, for weight distribution, because I won't be putting so much weight on this end, but all the weight will be here, which won't go anywhere. Then I grab some screws here. And I countersink them down as far as I can, about a quarter to a third of the way in to that piece of wood there. Right. Yeah, you see, one screw will pick it up pretty much with that piece there. That's what I'm wanting. Yeah, see? I picked it up, right? So, you know, it's not gonna go anywhere now. So that one there is done. And it's this one here now. Now, what will I use? To measure this, okay. To there. Right to there. That's where I'm wanting it to sit on this one. This one's the coffee table. So, exactly what I'm wanting. And I can pick this up. With one screw, right? Okay, sometimes my square bit gets stuck in the screw. But yeah, that's what I'm wanting is when it has the ability by that one going across. I probably put a few too many in there. But still, the point of that is I'm going into the grain, not across the grain. So these two outer ones might go, one in the middle might go because there's cracks and it'll crack. They're called checks when they go along the grain. From up down, up to along the grain there, from the top to the bottom of the tree. So I want to make sure that it's got a good hold. And I'm a believer on good craftsmanship, which you don't see very much anymore when you buy furniture. Because, yeah, look at that ceiling, right? It was redone by the previous owner, right? You know, I believe in good craftsmanship. So sometimes going overboard is good. I'm gonna glue the other top, and I will see you within a day or two for this project.